Hello viewers, welcome to LM Online classes. I am your Wali Sahib. In this video we are going to discuss about cofactors and coenzymes. So here on the basis of chemical nature, here enzymes are classified into two types. They are simple enzymes and conjugated enzymes or complex enzymes. So here the enzymes which are classified into two main types, they are simple enzymes and conjugated enzymes or complex enzymes on the basis of their chemical nature. So here coming to simple enzymes. Simple enzymes are pure protein forms of enzymes. Because of here, 99% of enzymes which are made up of pure proteins. So if we observe their chemical structure, they have only protein part in their chemical structure. So here, the enzymes which are made up of the pure proteins, they are called as here simple enzymes. So here, all these simple enzymes which are considered as here pure protein forms of enzymes. So here, the protein part which is present in the chemical structure of simple enzyme, that is here active. So here, the active form of protein part which is present in the chemical structure of simple enzyme. So here, the enzyme can accelerate or enhance the rate of the chemical reaction. Then, all these simple enzymes which give amino acids upon the hydrolysis process. So, but they do not produce any other chemical compounds during the hydrolysis process. So, here if you are simply saying as the enzymes which give only amino acids upon the hydrolysis, these are called as here simple enzymes. So, I will give some examples which are related to the simple enzymes. They are pepsin, trypsin and chymotrypsin. These are the different enzymes of simple enzymes. So, here pepsin, trypsin, chymotrypsin. These all are simple enzymes which have only protein part in their chemical structure. So here this kind of all enzymes which are considered as here the pure protein forms of enzymes. And then coming to conjugated or complex enzymes. So here the conjugated or complex enzymes which are made up of the both protein part and non-protein part. Protein part and non-protein part. So here the enzymes which are made up of both protein part and non-protein part, they are called as here conjugated enzymes or complex enzymes. So in the conjugated enzymes, the protein part is called as apoenzyme. The protein part is called as here apoenzyme. The non-protein part which is called as here cofactor. So if you observe the chemical structure of conjugated enzyme, it consists of both protein part and non-protein part. But the protein part which is present in the conjugated enzyme, that is here inactive. But when it will be activated? So here when the protein part of conjugated enzyme is associated with non-protein part, then the enzyme will be activated. So activated enzyme then accelerate or speed up the rate of the chemical reaction. So here in the conjugated enzymes, the protein part is apoenzyme and non-protein part is here cofactor. So here the both apoenzyme and cofactor combined together form a holoenzyme. Holo means total, complete chemical structure of the enzyme. That is apoenzyme and cofactor. So here both apoenzyme and cofactor which are present in the chemical structure combined together and to form a holoenzyme. So here all these conjugated enzymes which are also known as here holoenzymes. So here if we observe the structure of conjugated enzyme like this, this is the enzyme, and when it is associated with the non-protein part, it is a protein part, that is apoenzyme. This is the non-protein part, that is here cofactor. So here the protein part which is present in the conjugated enzyme, that is inactive, but it will be activated when it is associated with the non-protein part. So here the apoenzyme and cofactor both combined together form a holoenzyme. Holoenzyme, apoenzyme plus cofactor to form a holoenzyme. So here holoenzyme is a active form of enzyme. In the conjugated enzyme. So here holoenzyme, it is a activated form of enzyme. So here when the both apoenzyme and cofactor combine together form a holoenzyme. So here all these conjugated or complex enzymes which are considered as here holoenzymes are also known as here holoenzymes. Then the cofactor which is present in the conjugated enzyme, it is again three types. They are prosthetic group, and coenzyme, and metal ion. So here these are the three different types of cofactors which are present in the conjugated enzymes. So here let us see the definition of a cofactor. That is here, enzymes are composed of one or more or several polypeptide chains. However, they may require non-proteinaceous part, that is here cofactor. So here the cofactor is nothing but non-protein part of the conjugated enzyme, that is cofactor. So here the cofactor bound to the enzyme to make the enzyme catalytically active. So here without the cofactor the enzyme is catalytically inactive in nature, but when the enzyme is binding with cofactor and make the enzyme catalytically very active. So here active enzyme can involved in the chemical structure, can involved in the chemical reactions. So here this is about the definition of cofactor. And then the enzymes are again three types, prosthetic group and coenzymes and the metal ions. And then first we have to know about the prosthetic group. So here the prosthetic group is a organic cofactor. So here the organic cofactor which is binds very tightly with apoenzyme to form a prosthetic group. So here when the cofactor binds very tightly with apoenzyme, it is called as here prosthetic group. So here this prosthetic group which is involved in the catalytic activity of enzyme. So here all the prosthetic groups which are present in the enzymes, these are involved in the enhance or increase the catalytic activity of an enzyme. And then the prosthetic group is an organic cofactor which can enhance the catalytic activity of an enzyme. So for example, here the heme is a prosthetic group in the peroxidase enzyme. peroxidase enzyme and catalase enzyme. So here the peroxidase which is present in the peroxisomes. So here the enzyme which is involved in the breakdown of hydrogen peroxide into the water and oxygen. Water and oxygen. So here in these enzymes, the heme acts as a prosthetic group, which can enhances the catalytic activity of the peroxidase enzyme and catalase enzyme. So here the peroxidase enzyme and catalase enzyme without peroxidase or catalase enzymes not involved in the chemical reactions when they are not associated with the heme because of their catalytic activity decreases. When they are associated with the prosthetic group, that is heme, then their catalytic activity will be increased. So here after the increasing of catalytic activity of peroxidase, here the enzyme which is involved in the breakdown of H2O2 into H2O plus oxygen. So here this is the prosthetic group. And then coming to another cofactor, that is here the coenzyme. So here coenzyme is a organic cofactor. Coenzyme is also the organic cofactor, but which is binds with apoenzyme very loosely. So here very loosely the organic cofactor which is binds with apoenzyme to form a coenzyme. So here if we define the coenzyme as here, when the cofactor binds very loosely with apoenzyme, it is called as here coenzyme. So here coenzyme is a organic cofactor which binds very loosely with apoenzyme. So here this organic cofactor which is also involved in the catalytic activity of enzyme. So here without the coenzyme, here the enzyme catalytic activity is decreased. But when they are associated with some coenzymes, then they can increase their catalytic activity and involved in the acceleration of chemical reaction. So here the coenzymes, all the coenzymes are B complex vitamin derivatives. B complex vitamin derivatives. So here all these coenzymes which are derived from the B complex vitamins. So here the coenzymes which are also involved in the acceleration or enhance of catalytic activity of an enzyme. So here all these coenzymes which are derived from the B complex vitamins. But these are transient phenomenon. Here coenzymes are transient phenomenon. That means here coenzymes are transient phenomenon. That means they are only associated with enzymes partially. So here then very soon they are dissociated from the enzymes after the completion of a reaction. When they are required by the enzymes, then only they are associated with the enzymes. But otherwise, they are not associated with the enzymes. So here, let us see some examples which are related to the coenzymes. So here, the First one is here, the TPP, thiamine pyrophosphate. Here the thiamine pyrophosphate is a coenzyme which is derived from the vitamin B1, which is derived from the vitamin B1. So here vitamin B1 chemical name is here thiamine. Vitamin B1 chemical name is here thiamine. So here the another compound which is also present in the nucleotide, that is here thymine. Thymine is a nucleotide, nitrogen base, but thiamine is a vitamin B1. So here the TPP, thiamine pyrophosphate, is a coenzyme which is derived from the vitamin B1. And function, what is the function of TPP? So here it is mainly involved in the decarboxylation process. So here the transfer of carbon dioxide group from one substrate molecule to the another substrate molecule. So here decarboxylation, removal of carbon dioxide from the one substrate molecule to one substrate molecule. So here the TPP is a coenzyme which is involved in the decarboxylation reaction and derived from the vitamin B1, that is thiamine. And then the next one is here FMN, FAD, flavomononucleotide, flavoadenine dinucleotide. These both are coenzymes which are derived from the vitamin B2. The vitamin B2 chemical name is here riboflavin. So here these are derived from the vitamin B2. What is the function of FMN and FAD? These are responsible for the transfer of electrons from one substrate molecule to another substrate molecule during the oxidation and reduction process. So which are involved in the oxidation reduction reactions for the transfer of electrons from one substrate to another substrate molecule. And then the another coenzyme is here NAD plus and NADP plus. So here both are also coenzymes which are derived from the vitamin B3. The chemical name of the vitamin B3 is niacin or nicotinic acid. So here what is the function of coenzyme NAD plus and NADP plus? So here both are the coenzymes which are derived from the vitamin B3, which are involved in the transferring of electrons from one substrate molecule to the another substrate molecules during the oxidation and reduction reactions. And then the another cofactor coenzyme, that is here the coenzyme A. Here coenzyme A is a coenzyme which is derived from the vitamin B5. The chemical name of the vitamin B5 is here pantothenic acid. So here the function of coenzyme A, which is responsible for the transfer of acyl group, transferring of acyl group from one substrate molecule to another substrate molecule. So here the transfer of acetyl group from one substrate molecule to the another substrate molecule. So this is the function of coenzyme A, which is derived from the B5 vitamin. And then the next coenzyme is here, that is the pyridoxal phosphate, PP, which is derived from the B6 vitamin. So here the chemical name of the B6 vitamin is here pyridoxine. But what is the function of pyridoxal phosphate, which is acts as a coenzyme? So here this is mainly responsible for the transfer of amine group from one substrate molecule to the another substrate molecule. So which is mainly involved in the transamination process. amination process. So here the transfer of amine group from the one substrate molecule to the another substrate molecule. And then the another coenzyme that is here, biocytin. Here biocytin is a coenzyme which is derived from the B7 vitamin, that is here biotin, which is also known as here vitamin H. So here what is the function of biocytin, which is acts as here coenzyme, so which is mainly responsible for the transfer of carbon dioxide or carbon group from the one substrate molecule to another substrate molecule. So here the transfer of carbon dioxide, or particularly which is involved in the carboxylation reactions. And then the another coenzyme, that is here the dihydrofolate and tetrahydrofolate. So here DHF, dihydrofolate, and THF, tetrahydrofolate, both are also acts as here coenzymes which are derived from the vitamin B9, that is here folic acid. So here the function of folic acid or the dihydroxyfolate or tetrahydrofolate enzyme is here particularly responsible for the transfer of one carbon group from one substrate molecule to another substrate molecule. Here the transfer of one carbon group from the one substrate molecule to the another substrate molecule. This is the function of the dihydrofolate and tetrahydrofolate of the coenzyme. And then the another coenzyme which is derived from the vitamin B12, that is here the 5'-adenosyl cobalamin is a coenzyme which is derived from the vitamin B12, that is here the cyanocobalamin. And what is the function of here 5'-deoxyadenosylcobalamin, which is mainly responsible for the isomerism process, which is mainly involved in the isomerism process for the transfer of acyl group, or hydrogen group from one substrate molecule to another substrate molecule. So here these are the a few examples which are related to the coenzymes. And then coming to metal ions. So here metal ions are inorganic cofactors. Metal ions are here inorganic cofactors. So here when the enzyme associated with inorganic cofactor, that is referred to as here metalloenzyme. So here this is also involved in the catalytic activity of enzyme, So here the inorganic cofactor which is also involved in the catalytic activity of enzyme. So here when the enzyme which is associated with some cofactors are inorganic metal ions, these enzymes which are referred to as here metalloenzymes. Let us see some examples which are related to the metal ions. They are here boron. So here boron, which is acts as a cofactor for the enzyme, that is here enolase. So here enolase catalytic activity is increased or enhanced by the cofactor, that is here boron. And then the calcium Ca2+ ion. The Ca2+ ion which can increases the catalytic activity of lipase and succinate dehydrogenase. Lipase and succinate dehydrogenase enzyme. So here these are the two enzymes which can increases their catalytic activity when they are associated with cofactor, that is calcium. And then the another cofactor, that is here copper. So here copper, which can increases the catalytic activity of cytochrome c oxidase and tyrosinase. These are the most important points or important enzymes of here copper. So here the copper acts as a metal ion or cofactor which can enhances or accelerate the catalytic activity of cytochrome c oxidase and tyrosinase enzyme. And then the another cofactor, that is here cobalt, which can increases its catalytic activity in the enzymes of ascorbic acid oxidase and peptidases. So here ascorbic acid oxidase and peptidase enzyme, these both enzymes can increases their catalytic activity when they are associated with cobalt. So here the another coenzyme which can increase or enhance the catalytic activity of salivary amylase, that is here chlorine. So here chlorine is a another cofactor which is mainly responsible for the enhancing catalytic activity of salivary amylase. And then the next cofactor is here Fe2+ iron, Fe2+ or Fe3+. This cofactor which can increases the catalytic activity of aconitase catalase, peroxidase and cytochrome c oxidase etc. So here these are the main enzymes which can increases their catalytic activity by the iron cofactor. And then the next cofactor is here the potassium ions K+. This is responsible for the catalytic activity of pyruvate kinase. And then the another cofactor which is responsible for the catalytic activity of enzyme, that is here Mg2+. So here magnesium ions, which are also acts as cofactors for the catalytic activity of all kinases and DNA polymerases. Here polymerases enzymes are also can increases their catalytic activity by the magnesium, and all the ligases and also the enzymes of hexokinase, phosphofructokinase and pyruvate kinase, Rubisco and PEPKase. These are the different kinds of enzymes which can enhances their catalytic activity by the cofactor, that is here magnesium ion. And then the another cofactor, that is here manganese, Mg2+. So here it can increases the catalytic activity of an enzyme, that is here arginase and ribonucleotide reductase enzyme and peptidases and decarboxylases. So here these are the enzymes which can increases their catalytic activity by the cofactor, that is Mn2+. And then the another cofactor, that is here molybdenum. So here the molybdenum which can increases the catalytic activity of the coenzyme, that is here the dinitrogenase enzyme and nitrate reductase enzyme. These are the both enzymes which can increases their catalytic activity by the cofactor, that is molybdenum. And then the another cofactor, that is here sodium Na+, which can increases the catalytic activity of sucrase. And then the another cofactor which can increases the catalytic activity of an enzyme, that is here nickel. So here the nickel is also can increases the catalytic activity of an enzyme, that is here urease enzyme. And then the another cofactor, that is the selenium, which can increases the catalytic activity of glutathione peroxidase. This is the cofactor of glutathione peroxidase, that is here selenium. And then Zn2+, zinc, which can accelerate or increases the catalytic activity of the enzyme, that is here alcohol dehydrogenase, lactate dehydrogenase and carbonic anhydrase and alkaline phosphatase. So here and also the another one, the carboxypeptidases. So here these are the different kinds of enzymes which can increases their catalytic activity by the zinc, Zn2+. So here this is about the total cofactors and coenzymes information.